Hi guys, hope you're having a good start to your half term for those of you who are already on half term. Just give me one second, I just need to share this video as usual. We've not got any visitors just yet. Nobody online yet? Okay, that's fine. We are going to crack on with this demo anyway. And see how we go. Hi, Sonia. Right. Okay, so let's get started. We are going to do a demo for a rag rug or hoop rug, depending on where you look, it has a different name. So here is one we made earlier. I say we, actually, Big One made this by herself. This is actually for her doll's house. It needs a bit of work, but actually for a first attempt, I think she did really well. And she did this all by herself. I just set it up for her. So what you're going to need is a hula hoop or any kind of hoop really. We got these really cheap. As you can see, they're a bit bent. It's not really good for hoolering, but they're really good for crafting. I think we got ours from the pound shop just before it closed down, so they cost us like 50p. So your hoop. You will also need some old clothing. Any clothing as long as it makes a tube. So we've got t-shirts and we've got trousers. So what I mean by a tube is you want to have a seam down both ends. And then two openings. Okay. Now, there in the caption, you will find an instruction video on how to turn your jeans or your trousers into a continuous thread like this. So we have one made from white chinos, I think they are. They're not quite denim, but that's really good strong material. We have one made from denim. These were made from my own jeans. And we also have one made from t-shirt material, which is nice and stretchy. Whatever materials you want, as long as your clothing of choice makes a continuous tube, that should work just fine. Hi, Sam. Hi, Amanda. Thanks for joining me. We've only just about got started, so you've not actually missed anything. So, your hula hoop, you will need to make some loops like this. All you need to do to make these loops is just take your t-shirt and cut strips. Yeah, you'll need some really good strong fabric scissors for these. So you want to make some strips. You can make as few or as many as you want, and what you want to do is add them to your hula hoop. So here's one I prepared earlier. A little bit Blue Peter there for you. And you want to try and get them as even as possible and all meeting as much as possible in the middle. Okay, now when you use loops like this, you will end up with an even number of spokes. So these are the spokes. Because you're using a loop, obviously each loop has two ends, so you'll end up with an even number, but what you actually want is an odd number. So when you've got all of your loops on, however big you want to make it, you want to take two of them and just bring them together like this. Okay, so now you have an odd number. Okay, and I will start with the white so you can see the contrast. And don't forget, there's a video. I've already made the video for you. The link is tinyurl.com/upcycleyarn. Just to show you how I made a continuous strand of yarn from clothing, jeans, t-shirts, even sleeves, anything that forms a tube. Right, so you'll have an odd number of spokes on your hoop once you've joined two of them together. And what you need to do is you need to take one end of your yarn, okay, and you want to tie that together, tie it around two spokes. Your first one is two spokes together, like so, and you want to just slide that down to the middle. Yeah, Can you see that? Hopefully with the contrasting fabric, you can see that quite nicely. And this is so easy to make. As I say, this one was made by my seven-year-old. She did this by herself. I just showed her what she needed to do and she was off. She made this in about 10 minutes. And this is perfect size for her doll's house. So what you need to do, okay, so you start, you can use the ball like this. Some people use a weaving tool, but I think it's easier to do it like this. So each loop forms one spoke, okay? So you don't want to be going between the loops. You want to be using each one as a separate spoke. So you start off the one that you've tied off already, that can be your under, okay? So what you want to do is literally just go over and under or back and forth, however it is you're holding it. You just want to go over and under, yeah? So over one, under the next one. Now, if you want patterns, you can go over two, under two, however you like to do it, whatever you want to do. And you just want to keep going in and out, okay, all the way around, in and out. Make sure your spokes are separate enough so you can see the distinction there. If there's a problem, just move them by hand and just make sure to move them back when you're finished. Okay, so once you've got a complete circle, you've come all the way back to your double spoke. Now, as you can see, you've got one full circle here. Now you just want to scrunch it down, push it all down as far as you can. Just use your fingers for this and give it a bit of a tug. You don't want it too tight, but you don't want too many holes in it really. So you just want to push it all. As you can see, it's now starting to, if you can see that, it's, you need to cover up all of these holes as much as you can. So you just pull it nice and tight and push it down. And then you just keep going. So you keep going in and out, all the way around. I'm not sure how long it takes to make a big one. But as I say, my seven-year-old did hers in the space of 10 minutes, all by herself. And she made a lovely ribbon rug for her doll's house. So as you can see, yeah, it's getting bigger. When you make your yarn, as per the instruction video, you can make it as thick or as thin as you like. Obviously, it depends on how you cut it. Different materials obviously give different results. I use denim mostly because I have loads of jeans at home that are just not wearable anymore. And I'm just conscious of throwing away clothing, adding to landfills, that sort of thing. So this is quite thick, as you can see. You may want to cut it thinner. You may want strands like this from, this is jersey material from a t-shirt. This is nice and thin. You can have all sorts of colors, multicolored, single color, like these jeans here. Whatever it is you choose, really easy to do, really quick. If you use thick material, obviously it goes a bit quicker when you use thicker material. I'm just going to do a couple of rounds on this while I talk to you. Really easy to do. I like this because I love recycling, upcycling. I like making things into other things. And it's really good to teach the kids about recycling and how we don't want things constantly going into landfills. Hi, Ben. Hope you're good. I miss you. Yeah, so we're just going to keep going round. Okay. I will show you this in just a second once it's a little bit. I'm going to do another round or two and you'll see how it looks. Okay, and so this one at the moment is just white. Okay, let's go all the way around to my double spoke and I will show you how it looks and then we'll change color and you can see how it looks after that. Okay, and so we are back. Just about. You want to make sure your spokes are spaced as evenly as possible. Obviously with an odd number it can't be completely even, but Near enough. Okay, so we're back to the start. So can you see how it's starting to take shape? Yeah. And so if you want to change colours, which you can either add them all together. If you ball it all together, it's so much easier just to weave in and out with the ball. You can do smaller, more intricate designs. You might need a needle or a threader for that. So I've just cut that off. As you can see, I've left myself a little bit of length just here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my next colour of denim, which is just regular blue denim, and do a nice double knot. Sorry, you can't see this, but I'm doing a double knot, as you can see. Yeah, pull it nice and tight. Make sure it's pulled nice and tightly. You can see the knot there. Now, you don't want these bits sticking out, so you just trim those. Oh, this is why you need really good strong fabric scissors, because some of the material is a bit of a pain to cut. So there we go. Now we're literally just going to continue doing the same thing, going in and out. I will do some of this whilst I'm talking to you. Hi, Tammy. Okay, see, again, you just go over and under, over and under, round and round. You'll probably get dizzy. Now, sometimes your fabric will twist. As you can see here, we've started off with one side of the fabric and it's twisted. Now, that's not necessarily a problem unless, like me, you want it all to be uniform. So you just need to give it a twist as you're going round. Yeah, and it will twist just because of the way your yarn is on the ball, but you can just turn it round so it's all the same. So we've gone over that one, so we've gone under and over. Okay, and you just straighten it out like that. And as you can see, it's getting bigger and bigger already. If you use thicker yarn, obviously it will be much quicker to make, but you won't be able to get as many different colours if you use thicker yarn, and that's fine, whatever it is you prefer. And these are really great for, as you saw earlier, the doll's house. Let me just show you that one again, the little one for the doll's house. Fits beautifully. You can see it on the blog in place. The link to my blog is also in the caption just there. Or, you know, if you want them in the bedroom, if you like that kind of thing, wherever you want to put it. It's just fun to make, really. Kids love this kind of thing. It teaches them really good coordination. And it teaches them about not wasting things. Because, frankly, you know, we waste a lot of clothing. And the landfills are not going to be there forever, because eventually they will be full. And as you can see with this one, when it's straight, it comes out much nicer if you just do it straight. I mean, the middle one doesn't matter so much for me because it's white on both sides. But I wanted the denim to be uniform. And I'll show you why if I just go around this one more time. So we've got a double layer of the same colour. I will show you precisely why I'm being so particular on the colour. Oh, here we go. So we get all the way back round to the beginning again. Oh, hang on. Sorry, we're in a bit of a tangle here. Okay, so we've got, as you can see, we've got two layers now of the denim. And then if you just flip it over and start again, it's like you have a new colour without having to change your yarn. That's why I was keeping it nice and uniform, so then we can have it change in colour without actually having to stop and add another colour. Okay, so we're going to keep going round a few more, and then I will show you how we tie it off. So you might need to rewind every so often and untwist your yarn as you wish. Sometimes it gets a bit fiddly and you don't want to get all tangled up. I've done that. It's not fun. It's funny, but it's not fun especially if you're trying to make a live demonstration. Hi, Jordan. Hi, Nicola. Thanks for joining me, you guys. I will hold up what I'm making in just 1 second. Let me just go around again so that people can see. Okay, so we are back to the beginning again. And let me just flip the rest of that over. And so now, without even changing the yarn, we have another colour. So you can see the inside colour, inside of the denim is a slightly different colour. Okay, you can see that? So you literally just keep going round and round, as long as you want, as big as you want. Okay, I'm going to go round one more time and then show you how we cut it off. Just because this one's a quick demo. As I say, the video tutorial for making the yarn is here in the comments, not in the comments, in the caption rather. It's at tinyurl.com/upcycledyarn. That will take you to my YouTube video that shows you how I made one continuous strand from the leg of a pair of trousers. I also did one from a t-shirt. I used a sleeve for the first, for this one. But you can also use the body, as long as you've got a tube of fabric, as I say, so seams down both sides and then holes at either end. If you have a look at the video, it's probably clearer than my haphazard explanation. Right, we're just going to finish going, oh, don't drop your ball, because then you will get tangled. As I say, you can do this with thinner thread, yarn, wool. We picked up some great colours of wool from the charity shop. We got 6 balls of wool for £1, which is brilliant. We also picked up some clothing from the charity shop, because hauling my own stuff all the way to work every day is a bit tedious. So as you can see, it's growing bigger and bigger. Yeah. It's in and out, just simple weaving. You can do this by yourself, with your children. Your children can probably do it by themselves. As I say, the previous one was made by my 7-year-old, and she did this by herself. It's not as neat as she would probably have liked it, but for her first go, that was really good. Thanks, Nicola. Yeah, I was thinking of actually making a loom, a square or rectangular loom with a box frame. That's probably going to be another live. But yeah, I had a look around what I could do. We found these, as I say, we found these hula hoops in the pound shop. They were damaged, and the pound shop was closing down, so we got them for 50p. I can't remember if they were 50p each or 50p for both of them. Okay, so we're going to stop here for now, just so I can show you how we tie it off. Okay, so when you've finished, when you've reached your desired size, okay, you want to cut. Don't cut too close to your spoke, so you want a bit of excess length here. So we've gone two leg widths, as you can see, there's the hem, right? You literally just, so you decide which side you want to be your front, which side you want to be your back. I suppose it doesn't really make a difference until you start tying your yarn and you want to push all the knots to the back. So what we're going to do is, if I just hold that up there for you, so you're going to loop it around twice, yeah? And then you're going to do it a third time, but you're going to hold on to the loop and push it through, if you can see that. And that makes a nice little tight knot. Give it a good pull, yeah, just to make sure it doesn't come out. And then cut. And again, you want to leave a bit of extra just in case it comes unraveled. You don't want that to happen. So then when you've tied that all off and it's all nice and neat, you want to cut each of your spokes. So you cut them off right at the top. Now you need to leave enough length on your spokes so that you can tie them. I will show you what I mean just now. So here's our double one. Oh, yeah. So we're just going to cut all of them off, just right at the top. If you're like me, I basically put the hems right at the end, so they're easier to cut off then, they're the rough edges. And I did that pretty much all the way around, as you can see. So you cut all of these off. Okay, hang on. We've got a few more here. I'm just going to cut all these off together. Right. Oh, one more, still stuck. So we can now discard the hoop. And this is what you're left with. Okay, this one's a little bit looser than I would like, but that's probably because my yarn is quite thick. Now, let me see if I can hold it up whilst I'm tying. If not, I might have to angle the camera downwards. So you want to flatten it all out, okay, and have all of your spokes. No, you can't. This isn't working. It has to be flat. So I'm going to see if I can bring my laptop down. Just give me 1 second. Okay, that's a little bit better. You just won't get my face, which is not a problem. Okay, so what you want to do, because you have double loops, so you want to take one strand and one strand of the neighbor, okay, tie that. Do it nice and tight with a double knot, okay? And then do the same. So you take this one that you've already tied and its neighbor, okay, double knot, okay? And you'll end up with one slightly longer, and you just keep doing that all the way around. Just tie it and then go to the neighboring one. Keep tying all the way around, and then you can just trim off your excess. And you end up with a cute little rag rug. You can use them, as I say, a little one, big one rather, used hers for the doll's house, which looked great. You can make really big ones. If you can do it really neat, you can do them for your bedroom. You can use them as pot holders, put them underneath a vase, stick a vase on top so it doesn't scratch your table, that sort of thing. Really easy to make,